You can only say so after realization.
If we say, I am pure soul, does it not amount to an expression of ego?
No. If other people say it, then it is an egoistic expression. We have all decidedly realized that we are pure soul. And so it is not egoistic to talk about what you are. Many people can say, I am pure soul. But this is like someone telling you that he will give you $500 in his sleep. Would you believe him? It would be different if he were wide awake while making the offer. There is no meaning in saying things without awareness. In the same way, when people say, I am Shuddhatma, without acquiring self-realization, it is like they are talking in their sleep. They achieve nothing by talking this way, and in fact, such talk is liable to cause errors in life. One is only entitled to say, I am pure soul, after realizing the self.
So, the awareness has to occur?
Yes. Only after self-realization, one can say, I am Shuddhatma. Then, it is appropriate, because he is saying so after realizing his true identity, after becoming Shuddhatma. Now, if after becoming Shuddhatma, he asks for proof, then we can ask him who he is. He would answer that he is Shuddhatma. Next, we ask him if he has lost attachment to Chandulal, and he would say that he has. This confirms that he has become a pure soul.
The Gnani awakens your awareness.
After this Gnan, you recognize that your home is your real self and everything external to it is foreign.
That means your work is completed. This is like the man who is now alert and wide awake after someone wakes him up from sleep. He responds to his real name. Once made aware of your real identity as the pure self, you become awake. But as long as one has the belief, I am Chandulal, he is considered to be sleeping. A Gnani is able to destroy this wrong belief and awaken you to the right belief that you are Shuddhatma. Once this awareness becomes established within you, you become separated from Chandulal forever.
Awareness never before experienced.
Srimad Rajchandra referred to this as, through the supreme teaching of the highest guru, that is Sadguru, came the awareness never before realized. Self remains in the self, ignorance is gone forever. Prior to this Gnan, one is only aware of the body. The one who acted as Chandulal now reverts to the state of the self. That which was the original abode becomes the original abode, and the false abode of I am Chandulal is gone.
Becoming Nirvikal.
After Gnan, I am Chandulal is spoken for identification in worldly matters only. I am Shuddhatma, and this is mine, fall into their correct and separate places. After Gnan, the Sankalp, that is I am Chandulal, and the Vikalp, that this is mine, no longer exist. This is the Nirvikalp state. The Nirvikalp state is a state where one remains in the awareness of his real self. Nirvikalp state can only exist in the absence of Sankalp and Vikalp. Initially, you experience a taste of this Nirvikalp Samadhi, which progresses with time. But Gnan does not remain exact for you, because for endless lives, you have not experienced this real state. The experience of the soul is not easy to attain. One can keep on repeating, I am Shuddhatma, I am Shuddhatma, but the experience does not come. There is no other method to acquire the experience of the pure soul other than through the Gnan and the Gnani's grace. The acquisition of Gnan leads to Pratiti, that is conviction, Laksh, that is awareness, and Anubhav, that is experience. Furthermore, the conviction, that is Pratiti, never leaves.
Experience, awareness, and conviction.
What is conviction of the soul?
It is the conviction, I am soul, that becomes ingrained in one's being. This conviction has initially taken hold through the medium of words. Eventually, he will experience, I am soul. Your former conviction that you are Chandulal is now broken, and the absolute conviction that you are pure soul has been established, along with the Laksh, that is awareness of pure soul. Once you become pure soul, your liberation is guaranteed. There is absolutely no doubt about this. How much of the pure soul state do you experience? It is primarily from the conviction. If you are awakened in the night, immediately you become aware that you are Shuddhatma. This means that there is a 100% conviction and the awareness has also been established. Awareness, that is Laksh, means Jagruti, that is alertness or vigilance and state of spiritual awakening. This Jagruti will keep increasing until it becomes complete. Thirdly, you have the experience, that is Anubhav. It is due to this experience of the pure soul that you are attending satsang daily. Sat is absolute truth. Sang is association. You have tasted something and found sweetness in it. From now on, you will have experience, awareness, and conviction of your real self. This is a natural occurrence. The duration of time may vary. Experience and awareness fluctuate, whereas conviction of the pure state is constant. When the conviction is constant, such a state is called Kshayak Samkit. The conviction that fluctuates is called Samyak Darshan or Upsham Samkit. Awareness tends to change depending on what one is doing. If he is talking to someone, his awareness will not be there. As for experience, this occurs when he is alone. So, through these three aspects, conviction, experience, and awareness, that is Pratiti, Anubhav, and Laksh, all mental and bodily tendencies, that is Vrittis, that have wandered outwardly for endless lives, now revert to the self. They change direction, ending all aimless wanderings.
What kind of tendencies?
All kinds. These are of the chit, that is the component of inner vision and previous knowledge in the mind, those related to acquiring materialistic things, those wanting to experience sensual pleasures. There are many different kinds of tendencies. Those tendencies that used to wander in the marketplaces of the world now revert and return to the self and stop wandering.
दादा भगवान ना असीम जय जयकार हो
दादा भगवान ना असीम जय जयकार हो
दादा भगवान ना असीम जय जयकार हो
दादा भगवान ना असीम जय जयकार
हो The state of the self is absolutely pure.
After this gnan, your pre-existing illusion of I am the doer is shattered. You are absolutely pure. To perpetuate the state of the pure awareness, the state has been called Shuddhatma, that is pure self. It represents the awareness that is pure. Say Chandulal, that is your relative self, becomes angry and abusive towards someone. Even then, you, the soul, is completely separate and remains pure. In such negative circumstances, however, you have to ask Chandulal, why are you committing this aggression, that is atikraman, that results in unhappiness for the other person? Do pratikraman. If you have said and done anything that hurts others, it is an act of aggression. It is an atikraman, and therefore pratikraman should be done. Pratikraman means apologizing and asking for forgiveness from the other person. I have committed this fault, and I understand that it is wrong, and I am making a decision not to repeat this mistake again. Such a vow must be taken. If you commit the same fault again, then again you have to repent. You have to do it as soon as you realize your mistakes. In this way, your faults will decrease and eventually go away.
So, Dada, how should we perform pratikaman towards an individual?
Recall the pure soul, that is Shuddhatma, the one who is absolutely separate from the thoughts, speech, actions, bhav karma, that is charge karmas, dravya karma, that is effect karma, and no karma, that is neutral karmas, of that person. Recall the Shuddhatma that is separate from the name and all the associated attachment of that person. In this way, the pure soul has to be recalled. Then, Chandulal will need to recall his mistakes, that is Alochana. Repent for the mistake, that is Pratikraman, and vow never to repeat it, that is Pratyakhyan. You, the Shuddhatma, have to remain an observer of how Chandulal performs the Pratikraman and with how much sincerity.
Dehadhyas is, I am this body.
Ordinarily, people in this world are not able to let go of the awareness of I am this body. They are not aware of the real self. You, however, have received this gnan and are now without ego. I am Chandulal is egoism, and when the awareness of Shuddhatma is established, there is no attachment to anything connected with the body. Even then, initially, you will make mistakes and you may feel a sense of suffocation.
Prajna will alert you from within.
Because this gnan is scientific, you will experience it increasingly and it will automatically alert you from within. You will not have to do anything. The other traditional kramik path knowledge necessitates a doership on your part.
Yes, I experience something within that alerts me.
We have now found this path and have crossed the first entrance into the realm of Shuddhatma. No one can turn us back from here. What is it that warns you from within? It is prajna. Prajna is the direct light of the soul and it begins after this jnanvidhi. Prajna in the samkit state is like a partial phase. It is like the second day of the moon, that is like a sickle-shaped moon as compared to a full moon. For all those who have received jnan, prajna is fully expressed like the full moon. The full force of prajna keeps you constantly alert. Its role is to take you to the final liberation. King Bharat had to employ servants to warn him and keep him alert. His servants used to yell 3 times every 15 minutes. Be aware, King Bharat, be aware, King Bharat. On the other hand, prajna warns you constantly from within. That is the experience of the soul.
The steps of experience.
Dada, is it necessary to do anything further than the experience of the self?
Do you have the awareness of Shuddhatma all day long?
Yes, Dada.
Then what other experience is needed? That awareness itself is the experience of Shuddhatma. Go ask anyone in this entire population of India whether he has the awareness of Shuddhatma. After this jnan, the experience of Shuddhatma has occurred and its phases keep growing day by day. The enlightened world view itself is the experience of the soul. You have experienced the fact that you are Shuddhatma. That fact is decided. And now, there will be a gradual increase in this experience until you reach Keval Jnan, that is, absolute state. Keval Jnan is the state of complete, full experience. Currently, there is partial experience.